My name is Doron Levin. I'm a distinguished scientific associate for ExxonMobil Research and Engineering Company.
I'm Mohan Kalyanaraman. I'm a technology acquisition advisor with ExxonMobil Research and Engineering's planning organization.
My name is April Ross, and I'm a senior strategy advisor at ExxonMobil.
My name is Wenyih Frank Lai, or called Frank Lai. My current title is senior engineering associate for ExxonMobil Research and Engineering Company.
So there is a growing middle class in the world. As the number of people in middle class continues to expand, there is a demand for increased energy, and then there is also demand for higher performance materials, such as plastics. Paraxylene is really one of the key building blocks that we used to make a lot of plastics, such as the polyethylene terephthalate bottle that's in there, or for high performance clothing, or for home furnishings.
Paraxylene is produced in a chemical plant that's generally associated with a refinery. The reformer produces mixed xylenes. The challenge that we face is that what the industry wants is paraxylene, and what nature provides us with is essentially predominantly metaxylene and orthoxylene, which are different variants of xylene molecules. Only about 1 out of 4 molecules are the paraxylene. So this requires a lot of chemical reaction steps followed by separation steps, and as a result, these molecules go through this process, what we call the xylene loop, over and over again. And every time that you take these molecules at low temperature and you heat them up, that requires energy. And so what really drove this project was really a desire to be able to do this, not in the gas phase, but in the liquid phase. So this really requires a catalyst, and it was really the catalyst that's the enabler for this invention.
The most critical part of this process, you need a catalyst with very high activity to be able to operate in liquid phase, low temperature. So the critical component in the catalyst is indeed contain a molecule called GSN5 material. GSN5 is very, very unique material with a 3D structure and very desired pore size who can do the reaction, convert the reactant to the desired product.
You know, ExxonMobil has a real strong focus on energy intensity of the operations. We constantly strive to reduce that energy intensity in our operations. And so this is an example of an optimization and a process that enables us to use less energy to make the same product.
The first application of this technology was at our Rotterdam aromatics plant, and it started up in early 2015. Because of the energy reduction in this process, the energy reduction in the plant will be reduced the equivalent of around 30,000 Dutch households' average energy consumption. And the CO2 reduction will be on the order of taking over 23,000 cars off the Dutch roads.
This is an intermediate product that goes in, so it really does add to the marketplace as is. But the key is that when this was implemented, this again reduced the energy footprint of the operation quite a bit.
Well, this award is definitely very special. You know, Edison was a very prolific inventor, and to have an award in his name is a very special honor from both the council as well as our company for promoting.
This is my first time to get outside recognition, and to recognize we can move from discovery, development to commercialization and put a unit. This is how we feel very, very rewarded.
Internally, we have our own reward system, and that's all very nice, but it's really when you get an external recognition that there are other companies out there that recognize the value of what you do.
This is a really special award for us, and you know, not only us, but I think it recognizes all the people that have contributed behind the scenes.